Hello, Golden Jobbergs! Welcome once again to my channel. This is Sir Job and welcome to Sir Job TV. Para sa lahat po ng mga new explorers sa aking channel, yung newly discovered pa lang po ang aking channel, please don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell for you to be updated with my upcoming videos. So for this morning, another exciting topic in the discussion of understanding culture, society, and politics. So I will be discussing to you the causes of cultural change. Welcome to my video number 33. I hope you already watched my previous uploaded video, which is discusses about the components of culture. So for this vlog, I will be discussing to you the causes of cultural change. Ano ang mga dahilan kung bakit nagkakaroon ng changes ang isang culture? Okay, culture is not static. I know that you are already aware that culture is not static, meaning to say there is constant changes when we are talking about culture. While culture is preserved, it is always changing with the passage of time due to several causes. Okay, ano kaya ang mga dahilan kung bakit nagkakaroon ng changes ang isang culture? Okay, the first one is by means of discovery. So when we speak of discovery, it refers to the process of finding new place or an object, artifact, or anything that previously existed. Highlight po natin tong portion that states finding new place or an object, artifact, or anything that previously existed. So, if you observe in the status quo, in the interaction of social actors, nagkakaroon po ng discovery. That is why modernization comes in the interaction, or modernization comes in the society, because there is constant discovery of things. Okay, it also refers to the initial awareness of existing but formerly unobserved relationships, meaning to say andito na siya, existing na siya, pero hindi pa siya na-discover. Okay, so darating ang mga panahon na na-discover siya, or there would come a time that somebody can discover that particular thing. So that is why discovery is one of the things that will change or that will lead to the changes of culture. Example for discovery, we have the discovery of fire that led to the art of cooking. Remember, wala pang fire noon. If we have to discuss yung mga primitive culture, yung mga sinaunang tao, if you are discussing, mahirap po ang mag-create ng fire. So, one of the manifestations is the discovery of fire that led to the art of cooking. Very important po ito na discovery. Discovery of oil, of organism and substance, of diseases, of atoms, and sources of energy. So, these are the things that contributes to the development of the concept of culture. Again, the first one is the concept of discovery. Now, let us proceed to the second one, talking about the changes or the causes of cultural change. The second one is what we call invention. Okay, when we speak of invention, it implies a creative mental process of diverting, creating, and producing something new. Okay, novel or original. It implies the utilization and combination of previously known elements to produce an original or novel product. Invention can either social or material. Highlight natin pag sinabi natin invention, it implies a creative mental process of diverting, creating, and producing something new. So meaning to say, connecting into the first portion of the causes of cultural change, yung discovery, na-discover mo. Now, right after the discovery, the second step na mangyayari is the invention. Meaning to say, you will create something out from the discovery that somebody has done. For example, na-discover niya, this is the element. Now, we should have to think, what is the invention that might be created out from this particular discovery? So, that's how they are connected with each other. Do you get the point? Can you connect what I'm talking right now? Okay, very good. That's a very nice progress, I should have to say. Okay, let's put an example in order for us to strengthen our idea, okay, with this particular concept. Okay, when we speak of invention, invention of, sample natin ha mga examples. Invention of number system, okay? Invention of government, language, democracy, religion, and alphabet. Very important ang mga aspects na ito. Kung wala ito, I don't know if magkukontinue ba ang life or what life should be without this particular invention na nangyayari sa ating development. Okay? Mentioning the government, the language, democracy, religion, and alphabet. That's what we considered as social invention. Mga social inventions niyan. Okay. Invention of the wheel, machines, etc. These are the material invention. Okay? Material invention. So somehow it is connected to the concept that we have discussed on the previous videos na aking na-release, yung concept of material and non-material culture. Diba? This is how they are connected. The social invention and the material invention. Invention of new methods or techniques. So that's how we have to connect. Again, I'm clarifying that first you have to discover, and then the second step in the causes of cultural change would be the invention. Okay, now let us proceed to the third one. So the third one, causes of cultural change, we have the concept of diffusion. Ano ang ibig sabihin ng diffusion? By definition, it refers to the spread of cultural traits or the behavior of somebody or the practices, the kind of belief or the daily routine of somebody. Okay, spread of cultural traits, yan ang dapat i-remember niyo ha. Pag sinabi kong diffusion, it has something to do with spread of cultural traits. Example, we have religious beliefs, technological ideas, language forms, and etc. Or social practices from a society or group to another belonging to the same society or to another through social direct contact with each other and exposure to new forms. So meaning to say, by means of watching videos or by means of watching movies from different countries, we start to be diffused by the culture of other people. Okay, kasi ngayon very, modern, as I said to you, modern na ngayon, we're not only referring to by reading of books na natututo tayo sa iba't ibang culture from other countries, but nowadays, we also have our different videos, mga movies na pwede nating makita sa social media that will lead us to the appreciation of other cultures. Hindi na lang in our own culture but to other culture as well. Yung mga appreciations na ganyan, very na po siya ngayon, accessible na po siya in our generation. So that's what I'm talking about when we are talking of diffusion. Okay? You are being introduced, or aside from reading or watching movies sa different social media platforms, we could be able to personal contact with them, have personal contact with them. Like for example, you travel from different places, you will not stay there for a long time, pero since sa panahon ngayon, a lot of Filipinos also have the capacity to go to other countries for a travel, okay, as a tourist there. So basically, you will be exposed also with the other culture. That is one of ways na nadidiffuse tayo sa culture ng ibang bansa. That's basically what I'm talking about. Okay, let's continue. Direct contact is made possible through trade and commerce. Okay, isa din to sa nagbibigay ng reason kung bakit na-execute ang diffusion. Because of trade and commerce, business can lead us to connect with other countries. Basically, kasi nga nagbibenta ka, you have your product, in-export mo to other countries also will be exporting their products, and you will also importing with the product from other countries. So that's basically the point, that culture can also be diffused by that certain setup. Again, direct contact is made possible through trade and commerce with one another. And then the other one is conquest, and by means of conquest and colonization. So later I will be discussing what does it mean when we speak of conquest and colonization, and how it affects to our concept or to our main topic for this morning, which is the causes of cultural change. Let us continue with our discussion. Diffusion involves the following social processes. So meron pong mga parts ang tinatawag nating diffusion or the spread of a certain culture. So when we speak of diffusion, letter A, okay, na naka-attach po sa concept na ito, we have the concept of acculturation. What does it mean? When we speak of acculturation, you always have to remember, when we speak of acculturation, it has something to do with cultural borrowing or cultural imitation. Example, the Filipinos are said to be the best English-speaking people in Asia. Pag sinabi kong acculturation for a short period of time, you can execute this particular cultural aspect. You can actually execute this one because you just simply borrow or you just simply imitate them, okay? But you could also have this for a longer time. Like, for example, speaking the language English for the rest of your life. That is one of an example of cultural borrowing or imitation. You don't need to speak Filipino anymore. English for the rest of the discussions or the conversations with your friends, something like that. Or physically, you could also be acculturated. Okay? Like for example, you are fond of watching mga K-pop movies, okay, in Korea. So later on, you will just have to wear everything about their culture. So that is one of the examples of acculturation. Meaning to say, you borrow and you imitate their culture. Okay? It's not bad, okay? Kasi you are just simply borrowing or imitating their own culture. Hindi po nawawala ang pagiging isang Filipino mo by just simply acculturating yourself from the rest of the other cultures around the world. Okay, letter B. Aside from acculturation, we also have the concept of assimilation. Ano kaya ang ibig sabihin ng assimilation? Assimilation is blending or fusion of two distinct cultures through long periods of interaction. Okay? Ang highlight natin ang mga words na ito, blending or fusion. Pag sinabi kong assimilation, blending or fusion. Example for this one, Americanization of Filipino immigrants to the United States of America. Meaning to say, nagstay ka for a long period in the US. For instance, ipinanganak ka, then right after 3 years old, nag-migrate na kayo sa US, and for a longer time you stayed in America. That is one of the example of assimilation. Meaning to say, almost everything about the development of your life is actually patterned in the culture of United States of America. That is what we called assimilation, or the blending or fusion of two distinct culture. Kasi yung meron kang birth culture, as I said, always, hindi po yan mawawala sa iyo na you are a Filipino. But because of long exposure to the culture of America, because you stayed there for a longer time, then you are being blended with their culture there in United States of America. That's the point when we are speaking of assimilation. Let us proceed to the third one. We are still speaking in the concept of diffusion at this very moment. Okay, letter C. We have the concept of amalgamation. When we speak of amalgamation, it is the biological or hereditary fusion of members of different societies. Words that we need to remember here sa amalgamation is the biological or hereditary. Biological or hereditary. Okay, example for this one, marriage between Filipino and American. Okay, pag sinabi kong amalgamation, it's not only you are watching culture from other countries, or you are reading culture from other countries, or you visited a place outside from your own country. Hindi na po ganun ang amalgamation. Amalgamation is biological or hereditary, meaning to say nagkaroon ng intermarriages. It's a Filipina at nakapag-asawa siya ng isang American. Okay, yung anak nila nagkaroon ng amalgamation, or napasok po sa concept of amalgamation. Meaning to say, nagkaroon po ng mixed culture by means of biological or hereditary ang kanilang anak. Okay, naging Filipino-American na po siya because ang father niya is an American at saka yung mother niya is a Filipina. And take note, pag ang Filipino po ay nahaluan ng dugong banyaga, there is really a best result. Na-observe niyo naman po yan sa society na pag nag-invest po tayo ng mga foreigner as our partners in life and then nagkaroon tayo ng mga anak, they were evolved. I mean, mas evolved po sila over the physical features of the natural Filipino. But that is still within the jurisdiction of your choice. If you want foreigners or if you want Filipinos to be your partners in life, that's your point at the end of the day. But again, when we are talking about amalgamation, it is the concept wherein there is a mixed culture of that particular child by means of hereditary or biological aspect. Okay, let us proceed with our discussion on letter D of diffusion. Under diffusion, we have enculturation. Ang word na ito very common sa inyo because I already explained this one sa aking mga previous videos. Pag sinabi natin enculturation, it is deliberate infusion of a new culture to another. Okay, it refers to the gradual acquisition. Yun ang ating i-remember. It refers to the gradual acquisition of the characteristics and norms of a culture or a group by a person or another culture or etc. So, highlight natin ang words na or line na the gradual acquisition. Okay, example, the teaching of American history and culture to the Filipinos during the early American regime. Ako talaga ang always ko mare-remember pag i-discuss ko ito, and the best example na mare-remember ko is our ancestors, yung mga lolo at saka lola natin, kung na-observe ninyo, mababa po ang kanilang educational attainment, but they can speak English very well. Unlike sa ating generation ngayon, graduate ng kolehiyo pero hindi halos makaspeak ng English. Pero noon sa ating mga lolo at saka lola, if you can observe, hindi po sila nakarating ng kolehiyo but they can speak the language. Why? That is the example of enculturation. Because long ago, when the Thomasites came here, yung mga first teacher natin dito, the American soldiers na nagturo sa atin dito sa Philippines, of course, ang itinuro talaga nila is the American history, everything about America, and of course, the medium of instruction is English. So that is why ang mga Filipinos noon, even if mababa lang ang kanilang educational attainment, they have been acculturated to the culture of the Americans. And the acquisition of language or of English language is one of the manifestation that they gradually acquire that particular language because of that particular exposure as well. So basically, that's how enculturation can be applied in the diffusion as far as cultural, as far as causes of cultural change is concerned at the very end of day. Now, let us proceed to number 4. In the number 4, we have here, because kanina nag-mention tayo na number 1, 2, and 3. 1 is discovery, 2 is invention, 3 is diffusion, and number 4 is colonization. Ano ang colonization in the first place? It refers to the political, social, and political policy of establishing a colony which would be subject to the rule of governance of colonizing state. It is politically termed as imperialism. Colonization, very common ito sa atin. We have been colonized by the Americans and also with the Spaniards. For the Spaniards, we have 333 years to be exact. Grabe, ang haba po ng panahon ng mga Spaniards ito sa atin. So in the Americans, they also have colonized the country long before. Right after, with the presence of the Spaniards, sila po ang pumalit sa atin to control. So that's basically the point. Pag sinabi natin colonization, ito yung pag-control sa political, social, and even the economic aspect of a certain country, controlled po siya ng isang colonizer. So that's basically what I'm talking about. Politically speaking, it is termed as imperialism. Okay, once the economy of a more technological advanced country dominates the economy of a less developed state, such condition is termed neocolonialism or economic imperialism. So generally, the superior culture of the colonizer is diffused into the colonized territory. So that's basically the point. So balikan natin yung kanyang line. The concept of colonization, again, focus our attention here sa portion na ito. More technologically advanced country, meaning to say first world country, example na lang natin ganun, and then kinontrol niya ang third world country. Okay, like for example, America, first world country sila. And then they controlled Philippines, we are in the third world country. So, ganun yung parang relationship. Kinontrol na niya ang economy, political setup, the people. So, if we are talking of the Americans, I have to, the best thing that you could be able to think is the mental conditioning that they have been introduced to us long before. Kasi ang tingin talaga ng mga Americans, once they have controlled already the mindset of the Filipinos, then forever we're being colonized by them. So, kung ma-observe ninyo ngayon sa ating status quo, we love America, we love everything from America, and everything about them, we embrace perfectly, or parang there's no question about it. Ang taas ng tingin natin sa kanila because of the long exposure or of those particular periods that we are under the jurisdictions or the power of the American people. So that's basically the point when we are speaking of colonization. So almost every aspects of that particular country is being controlled by a certain colonizer. Okay? So I hope that you already understood what I'm talking about here. In the discussion of the causes of cultural change. Example here, we have the Hispanization of Filipino cultures or the American global hegemony. Okay, yung sinabi ko kanina na Hispanization of Filipino cultures because we have been colonized by the Spaniards for a long time, and American global hegemony or influence because of that particular mental conditioning that I told you a while ago kung paano tayo nila kinontrol when it comes on how they introduce their products to us, how they introduce their business to us, and everything about America. So that's really the concept of the American global hegemony. We are talking about the influence of the Americans to the lives of every Filipinos at the end of the day. Now let's proceed our discussion with the fifth one, which is the rebellion and revolutionary movements. When we are speaking of rebellion and revolutionary movements, this aim to change the whole social order. Again, this aim to change the whole social order and replace the leadership. They challenge the existing Fuqueis and Mores, propose a new scheme of norms, values, and organization. Revolutionary movement involve more radical, if not violent, changes in society. So, ano ito? Anong rebellion at ano ibig sabihin ng rebellion and revolutionary movement? From the line, na-observe natin, this aim to change the whole social order and replace the leadership. Meaning to say, you are constantly fighting with the administration. You are not supporting with the government. You want change. Gusto ko ng pagbabago. Common po ito nangyayari noong panahon ng colonization because they are aiming to overthrow the power of the colonizers. Of course, they were suffering at the time. So ang goal talaga nila is mapatalsik ang mga colonizers dito sa ating bansa. So that actually the starting point of the concept of rebellion and revolutionary movement. But today, may mga bagong version na po ang rebellion at saka revolutionary movement. Wala ng colonizers sa Philippines, pero ang kalaban naman ng mga Filipinos, kapwa nila mga Filipinos, no? Ang government of the Philippines na naman ang gusto nilang kalabanin. So, I hope you have to think in doing such because, you know, the downfall of your government is also the downfall of the people. So, kung masira po ang Philippine government, masisira po ang buong Pilipinas. So, dapat you have to think about it na, will it support our government? Because this is basically our country at the end of the day. Okay, example for this one, we have the Philippine Revolution of 1896. Kung nakakuha na kayo ng subject na History 1 or readings in Philippine history, of course, you are being exposed already from this particular concept. The Philippine Revolution of 1896, the insurgency movement as the Hawk Rebellion and MNLF. So that's the example for rebellion and revolutionary movement. So recapitulate lang tayo for a moment before we have to close this particular video. I am talking now with the causes of cultural change. Pag sinabi natin causes of cultural change, meron po tayong limang concepts na dapat maintindihan. The first one is discovery, second is invention, third is diffusion. Under diffusion, we have acculturation, assimilation, amalgamation, and enculturation. So number four would be the colonization, and number five, rebellion and revolutionary movements. So that will be all for this morning. I hope you learned something from this video, and I hope that you will share this video to your friends and to anybody else that you think kailangan ng video na ito. Asahan niyo po that Sir Jug TV will continue to give you meaningful discussion, especially in the field of social sciences. Thank you once again for watching. Bye-bye!